Thank you. Good morning. Welcome to our worship service at the First Unitarian Church of Worcester, Massachusetts. I'm Sarah Stewart. I'm the minister here. It's wonderful to have all of you with us this morning. I'm leading worship this morning with our director of music, Will Sherwood, our assistant director of music, James Haupt, our director of faith development, Juliet Donaldson, our children's coordinator, Abigail Hannaford-Ricardi, and Darren Belanger, our broadcast tech. Blaine Burchard and Paul Popenchalk are volunteering as our camera operators, and Karen Riley is our head usher. On this Music Sunday, we are especially pleased to have many guest musicians joining us in the orchestra and in our choir. Their names are listed in your order of service. Here at First Unitarian Church, we strive in loving fellowship to honor the sacred, connect with each other, and serve justice. We are a welcoming congregation. Whatever your age, race, class, nationality, sexual orientation, or gender identity, we are delighted to have you with us this morning. We are worshiping as one congregation in many places. We have people here in the sanctuary and people joining us online. If you're here in the sanctuary while keeping your mask on, feel free to participate in all the unison prayers and readings and sing the hymns. If you are at home, the words to readings and hymns will appear on your screen so you can join in as well. All are welcome to join us for social hour in the church parlor through either door at the front of the sanctuary. This door on my left is the accessible entrance. If you go all the way through into the dining room, you'll find coffee and refreshments, and you may remove your mask while eating and drinking. However, if you prefer to be wearing your mask all the time with other people who are also wearing their mask, then stop in the first part of the parlor, the Bancroft Room, which is a space where masks are required, and we have a wall that closes between the two spaces. It's a nice day, so feel free to take your refreshments and coffee into the garden as well. I want to let folks know that we are beginning a new member class this Sunday. There will be three meetings after church on the first Sunday of the month. This is the first one. So if you have been thinking about joining First Unitarian Church and are interested in coming to that class, we'll be meeting downstairs. The stairs are right here out this door, or you can take the elevator to the Myrick Room at noon, where we'll have some snacks and get to know each other as possible people interested in membership at the church. Those of you online, you can like this video to help others find us and subscribe to our channel for more content, including many more videos of music from over the years. The newsletter is the best way to stay in touch and join all of our programs. If you're here in person, you can stop at the welcome table in the Bancroft Room to sign up for our newsletter. And anyone can go to our website, firstunitarian.com, and click subscribe to our newsletter at the bottom of any page. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
In the spirit of love,
we light this chalice. Please rise in body or spirit to renew the covenant of our church with the words in your order of service or which appear on your screen. In the love of truth and in the spirit of Jesus, we unite for the worship of God and the service of all. Number 114 in your gray hymnal, Forward Through the Ages. Thank you. this morning, we're going to ask that our children stay in their seats for this morning's story. You'll still be able to see it up on the screen. So we have been learning wisdom stories from the Jewish tradition. And today, in honor of our Music Sunday, we have a special story called Chava Nagila. Chava Nagila, Chava Nagila, Chava Nagila, Ben Yismucha. Chava Nagila, Chava Nagila, Chava Nagila, Ben Yismucha. It looks like our village butcher enjoyed that tune.
Yeah, I know that tune. That's Chava Nagila.
Ah, and here comes the village baker. I know that tune too, but I wonder, what does Chava Nagila actually mean? The butcher thinks he knows.
That's easy. It's the Jewish wedding dance I've seen YouTube videos.
A dance?
Yeah. After they get married, they sit down in chairs and they get raised up into the air and everybody dances all around them. It's a wedding dance.
Wait! Oh, here comes the baker's daughter. Mom, that can't be right. It has nothing to do with weddings. Don't you remember when I went to my friend's bat mitzvah and they sang it all at the reception afterwards? It's a song. It must mean coming of age. I'm just sure of it. And here comes the candlestick maker.
Well, I couldn't help but overhearing, and I have to tell you I'm sorry, but you're all wrong. Chava Nagila is the Hebrew word for feast.
Feast?
Yep, feast. I mean, the only time I've ever heard it, there's been a feast. Think about it. Went to a wedding, what was there? Feast. Go to a bar bat mitzvah, what is there? Feast. Go to a Hanukkah party here, you go upstairs, what is there? Lots and lots of food. In fact, now that I'm thinking of it, maybe Chava Nagila is a kind of food. Something deep fried in oil and filled with something fruity.
The baker's laughing at you. I'm sorry, but that's not Chava Nagila. You're thinking of tzufganiyot. Those are just jelly donuts. No, you know, the more I think of it, I think Chava Nagila must be a prayer.
A prayer?
Yeah, a very deep religious prayer, beseeching God for a brighter tomorrow. That's why they say it at weddings, to wish the couple a fruitful future. And that's why they say it at bar and bat mitzvahs, to pray for a good life, a life as an adult with a beautiful, good future. Well, the candle maker is not convinced.
Well, I still say it has to do with food. But if you're not going to take my word for it, I did happen to pass the rabbi on the village green on my way over here. Let's just go ask her. She'll tell you.
Oh, it looks like they're going to go with that advice. All right. Oh, here comes the rabbi. Yep. And it looks like maybe the daughter's going to be the first one to reach the rabbi. Rabbi, Rabbi, Chava Nagila, it means coming of age, I'm just sure of it. But before the rabbi can answer, here comes the butcher.
Rabbi, would you please tell these good people that Chava Nagila is a Hebrew word for the wedding dance?
And now comes the baker. Rabbi, surely it's a prayer to God asking for a brighter tomorrow. And the candlestick maker.
Oh, sorry about all this, Rabbi. I tried to tell them it was food, but they wouldn't believe me.
And finally, the rabbi can get a word in. Ah, Chava Nagila. There's great wisdom in those words.
But what does it mean?
Well, perhaps this congregation can help you. I'm going to say a line to them, and I want you to listen very carefully to what they say back to me.
Are you ready? This is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Did you know that that's the 24th line of Psalm 118? What's the matter, Baker? You're still looking a little confused. Well, Rabbi, no offense. I mean, wow, that congregation's really impressive. I mean, no rehearsal or anything, but Rabbi, you are kind of talking in circles. What exactly do the words Hava Nagila mean? They mean, let us rejoice, let us rejoice, let us rejoice, rejoice and be glad. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice, let us rejoice, rejoice and be glad. Bring on the music now, start up the dancing too. Let's all sing and play, rejoice and be glad. Awake, awake, brothers, awake now, brothers, rejoin your hearts. 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 Awake now, brothers. Awake now, sisters. Sing out with joy in your hearts. And now our children are going to be sung out by us as they follow Juliet up to the Agora.
We enter into a time of silent prayer and meditation. We hold the joys and sorrows of this church in our heart. We reach out to one another in compassion, across the distances that separate us and across the barriers that keep us alone, as we say together the prayer of Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. All of us are beauty's handmaidens. It reproduces itself in us. Beauty grabs our attention. It displaces us from the tyranny of our self-absorption. Beauty does two things to us. The first is that it shunts us out of our delusion that we are the stars of the story. Whether we gaze on a wren hopping along a stone wall, or smell the soft head of an infant, or hear the strains of Mozart's Requiem, we are no longer the centerpiece. We become the beholder. The beauty which our senses perceive becomes the most important thing, and the thing which has sometimes against our will grabbed our attention and made us pay homage. But beauty goes beyond that. The second thing it does is reproduce itself through us. Because we may hear this requiem this morning and then hum a piece of it later on this afternoon and recreate a piece of its beauty as we do that. We may share this recording with friends, passing the beauty along. We may even practice an instrument or take up painting to get that inspiration down on the canvas. Or seek out beauty elsewhere in the world just to help us recreate the experience of experiencing something beautiful. Beauty is like an antivirus. It uses our minds and souls to replicate itself, bringing us more well-being and contentment as it does so. During the shutdown of the pandemic, we relied on this quality of beauty, especially through music. Suddenly, first in the spring of 2020 and again last winter, many of us were stuck at home. We couldn't go to concerts, we couldn't visit museums, we couldn't see the beauty of new babies in the extended family. We couldn't hear art or witness art performed live. Yet we could still listen to music. And what a comfort it was to hear the beauty of music we loved, reminding us that choirs, orchestras, and bands had once been possible and would be again. It brought us hope. To know that someone else had been spoken to in their soul such that they wrote the music, and someone else had decided to perform it, and some particular performers had recreated it, and now we were listening. Music connected us to one another across distance and time. It gave us faith in the perseverance of the human spirit. Mozart composed this requiem near the end of his life. In fact, he did not finish it before he died. He wrote it during his final illness, with full knowledge of the certainty that all our lives must end in death and that his own death was near. His requiem, the Mass for the Dead, displays his calm acceptance of death, a companion which he called the best and truest friend of mankind. Because Mozart's faith told him that a better world awaited human souls in unity with the divine. So the beauty of this particular music does more than connect us across the distances that still separate us, or the centuries that have passed while performers have performed and appreciated this particular work of beauty. It connects us to those who have gone before, whose spirits still live in our hearts, and whose souls we commend to God's loving embrace. When the bells ring at the end of the requiem, I invite you to bring to mind your own beloved dead, whose memories are alive in you still. I love you all. Amen. Our ministries at First Unitarian Church, such as our music ministry, continue to thrive because of your support. In the past week, youth and adult volunteers prepared the sanctuary for this Music Sunday, including setting up the risers and the music stands. Your stewardship team has begun conducting follow-up phone calls to invite members to give support to the church in 2022. And leaders attended the ribbon cutting of the new courthouse lofts next door, a renovation which includes more than 45 units of workforce housing. Your offering makes a difference. Thank you for your generosity. The ushers will receive the morning's offering, or you can use the QR code in your order of service. If you're online, you can text the number on your screen or go to firstunitarian.com and click Give Online at the top of any page. I invite your generous contributions for the good work of First Unitarian Church. Thank you.
Thank you. Spargenso.
Thank you.
Our closing hymn is Praise My Soul, the God We Sing Now. Words and music are in your order of service or appear on the screen. Please rise in body or spirit to sing. Peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor everyone. Love and serve the holy, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit forever. Amen. Please be seated for the postlude.
Bravo. Oh, Amanda, congratulations.